In this video, you will learn about an amazing tool, Unity Style Maps. I will tell you how to create and paint on tile maps. I will reveal hidden features of Unity Style Maps that not every developer knows. And also, I will show you how you can manage your tile map during runtime. This is no longer a boring static tool that you can paint levels with. This is a powerful feature that will make your game development easier. Interested? Continue watching. Hey, hey, it's Tamara here. Let's start with an introduction to Unity Style Maps. What is it and how do we use it? Unity manual says that it's a system which stores and handles tile assets for creating 2D levels. It transfers the required information from the tiles placed on it to other related components such as Tilemap Renderer and the Tilemap Collider 2D. By the way, Unity manual is a treasure itself because it contains information about all the features available in Unity. You can find a lot of useful methods and properties there that you might not know about. Some systems that you're desperately searching on the internet are already built in Unity. You just have to discover them by reading Unity's manual and watching my videos, of course. So, back to the tile maps. You probably know them as a way to use level tiles to paint static levels for side view platformers. Of course, this is a good way to use them, but that's not everything they can. But first thing first, let's look at how to create tile maps in Unity and paint tiles in them. Let's start by importing the tilemap editor in Unity. For this, go to Windows, Package Manager, and then select Packages Unity Registry. Find 2D tilemap editor and click Install. After the installation is complete, we can proceed further. Click on the hierarchy and create a 2D object. Tilemaps are considered 2D objects, but the truth is, you can use them in 3D projects. I just recently discovered this and you will be seeing some tutorials on this topic. Like this video and subscribe to my channel if you're looking forward to these videos. Unity offers different options for tilemaps like rectangular, isometric and hexagonal. We will take a rectangular as an example, but the methods I will show you today can be used in any of them. Tilemap object is the same for all of them. What changes is the shape and size of a cell on the grid. We can see our tilemap in the scene. We click on the grid object and see the components of it. Grid component has cell size, cell gap, you can use it to make tiles sit tighter together or vice versa, more apart. Cell layout, where you can change grid type to isometric for example. And cell swizzle, this impacts how the tilemap will be rotated and how we will treat coordinates. Now, click on the tilemap object. We have tilemap with color field. This can be used to disable tilemap without actually disabling this object. Just set the opacity to 0. It can be useful for a building system. You can still have the tilemap with information, but the player doesn't see it. And also, we have a tile anchor, how a tile is going to be centered. Next, we're going to paint some tiles on the tilemap. First of all, prepare the graphics for your grid. You can get them from Unity Asset Store and other resources, or you can paint them yourselves. For a regular grid, you just need to create a square. We need to create a tile palette. Go to the Windows, 2D and Tile Palette. This will open a window to manage our palettes. Click on New Palette, set a name for it and choose grid type. Also, you can change the tile size to your preference. If you change it on your grid object, do the same here. Click Create. I recommend saving it in a separate folder, so go ahead and create it. Now, drag our tile graphics on this tile palette. Give this tile some name, like white tile, and save it in our folder. If you see that this is too large, you can set the pixels per unit on sprite to a larger number. This is the right way to resize graphics in Unity. We have a few tools on the top panel of Tile Palette window. You can read the tooltip to understand what each tool does. Select Brush, choose Tile from the palette, go to the Scene view, make sure that you have the right tilemap object selected and paint some tiles on it. You can see that the tiles are too big, so go ahead and resize them. Also, I set Tile Anchor to 0 on both axes, which caused this effect. To get tiles back to normal, change the Tile Anchor to half. This was a simple way to use tile maps in Unity. It is useful to create levels for side view platformers or top-down maps. But that's not all Unity has to offer. Let's explore more. First enhancement is elevated tiles. This is usually seen in isometric games, so I will show you on an isometric tile map. To implement this, click on the grid object and create another tile map. It will be a child of our grid, so it will have the same size as the first one, but it will have a different tile anchor. For example, if you had zeros and all axes on the first tile map, you can set it to 0.5 on the X and Y on the second tile map. This way, the tiles on this tile map will be elevated by half, and if we set it to 1 and 1, there will be an illusion that they stand on the previous layer. Secondly, we can add colliders to tile maps. You can select any tile map and add a component to it, Tilemap Collider 2D. This can be done to prevent player from leaving the map, you just build a wall around the map and add collider component to it. Also, somebody asked me about stairs in isometric tile maps. This can be done using a little trick. Create line sprites that will align with stair sides and tile sides. Make tiles out of them and paint with them on a different tile map. Add collider to that tile map. Now you can use tiles with slopes and staircases. Another cool thing about tiles is that they can be animated. This another requires installation of another package called 2D Tilemap Extras. Go to the package manager again, choose Unity Registry and find 2D Tilemaps Extras. If you can't find it in the package manager, you can still download it from Unity's GitHub and import it in the file manager. But if you're using newer versions of Unity, it should be fine. So, to create an animated tile, click on the files, create 2D Tiles Animated Tile. Now, in the inspector view, you can type how many sprites in this animation, and then fill the list with your graphics. You can play around with parameters like animation speed and start tile. After this, you just drag it on a palette and use it like a regular tile. To see the animation, you have to enter the play mode. These tiles can be super useful for water tiles, lava, fire, or maybe even windy grass. 2D Tilemaps Extras package also contains another super useful tool called Rule Tile. This is a tile that obeys some rules when you paint them. For example, it will set different tiles on the edge of an area and in the center of it. Instead of just manually putting together different tiles on the edges, this tile will be handling it by itself. To create such tile, you have to click on the files, create, 2D, tiles and choose Rule Tile. In the inspector, you can add tiles and set rules in them. Just remember that if a tile can be connected from one side, that side has to have a green arrow. And if a tile cannot be connected from that side, put a cross there. When you paint on your tile map with this tile, it automatically adjusts depending on the position of it. Where to use them? Well, level painting, roads, grass, ponds, etc. And moreover, you can use it runtime for painting paths. But we will talk about scripting later. Stay tuned. All these tools can be explored further in more detailed tutorials, but it is great that you now know about them and can think of different ways to use them. Now, let's take a look at more advanced way to use Unity's tilemaps. And this means that we will deal with scripting and handle grid and tilemaps during runtime. Let me just say first that Unity already has all the stuff you need for handling grid placement. Some people still don't like to use them and prefer to write their own grid script, but I say why not use what the engine has to offer. So let's take a look at Unity's documentation and discover what we can do with grids and tile maps. Whoa, this is a lot! You can read about all of them after watching this video, but I want to tell you about the most important and give you the idea where to use them. Tilemap inherits from a grid layout, so every method that you see in grid, you can use it on tilemap. One important thing to remember is that it uses vector 3 int instead of a regular vector 3. It just means that all coordinates are int values. This is how a cell position is represented. First, you see a bunch of properties, some of which are also visible in the editor. You can access them from scripts, and I find tile anchor useful if you want to instantiate an object and make it seem like it is standing on that level of tiles. Then we have the methods. You can use clear all tiles if you want, for example, to reset tiles for a new level. You can check if the tilemap has a tile with contains tile method. Now, one of the most useful methods here is getTile. It accepts a position and returns a tile base at that position. You can compare this tile to another and see if a tile is taken or not, what kind of terrain it is, etc. A similar method for this is getTilesBlock. However, I had some issues with this one. It caused my editor to crash. I recommend using getTile method to write a custom getTilesBlock. It uses bounceIn to indicate the position and area size on which we get tiles. Vice versa, there are two other methods to set tiles on the tile map. Next, we have an event that the tiles are changed. After this, we have inherited members from grid layout. You can get properties like cell size and gap. Very useful methods here are for coordinate conversions. You know how you can convert from screen coordinates to world with methods in a camera class? It is like that, but with a grid. You can make grid snapping using this method, get position to instantiate an object following the grid lines, and other cool things that you can think of when making a game. These methods are incredibly useful when dealing with isometric games. All of that complex math about converting from one coordinate system to another is no longer necessary. Just use this and make your life easier. Yet another cool thing about tiles, you can make a custom tile script and store data in tiles. Using getTile method, you can retrieve data from such tiles. To create a custom tile, you have to create a script, call it whatever you want. Then, in the script editor, make the script inherit from tile. Create a set menu about the script. And write some fields, like this float speed. In the editor, you can fill in the fields like sprite and speed, drag it onto our palette and treat it like a regular tile. To get data from that tile, you have to use method getTile, but as a custom tile. Check if it is not null and access the field you want. To change the data, you have to refresh the tile at that position. I just want to say that it is not the end about tile maps in Unity. You can definitely explore more, so I recommend looking up in Unity's documentation to get more details about each cool thing that I mentioned on this video. Now, when you know these things, your development will become more professional. These are just things that are hard to discover on your own because you don't actually know how they code and what they do until you actually see them. It is time to build up on that knowledge. What makes a good developer is a broad knowledge of tools that you can use. You can think of different ways to use this knowledge in your systems. And if you need some help with exploring, join the Discords and drop your suggestions for future videos there. Also, like this video and comment down below if you found something useful in this video. Subscribe if you'd like to see more, and see you soon! Bye!